Hi! Time to take a closer look at some laser pointer safety issues you likely haven't heard about before. Most laser pointers are designed to be as cheap to build as possible. Safety features are rarely considered since they add costs. Or maybe the manufacturers are simply unaware of the safety issues with their cheap designs. The users shouldn't be. Are case-positive batteries always safe in case-positive laser pointers? Is the polarity of a battery case always positive? And can you even add batteries to your laser pointer without accidentally turning the laser on? Let's explore some dumb designs. When experimenting with a laser, wear safety glasses suitable for its wavelength and power output, and never short-circuit a battery. This is my very first laser pointer. I still like its sleek, minimalistic design. But I have to admit, this early design has some major safety issues. Biggest one is how the clip is the on-off button. It is awkwardly placed compared to modern designs, making a mishap due to fumbling more likely. But the worst part is while you put batteries in the laser. The clip very easily touches the aluminium case, randomly turning the laser on from just screwing on the end cap. Lasers are only safe if you are in full control of when the beam turns on. With the clip acting as the contact, they also had to make the end cap electrically insulating. It is therefore made of non-conductive plastic. A plastic thread going into an internal metal thread is not a durable design choice. And the more the plastic threads are worn, the more slack for this to happen. A less obvious safety concern is how the inner surface of the tube, the battery compartment, is uncoated aluminium. Now, placing batteries in series in a tight, highly conductive metal tube is inherently a bad idea, especially when the tube is too tight for the battery standard it is meant for. At some point, I forced one of these batteries into the pointer, scraping back the sticker, so I had to peel some of the creased sticker off. This is bad. I really like these rechargeable water batteries. They charge to higher than advertised capacity, even after years of use. Perhaps because they are made as big as allowed. A standard AAA battery is max 10.5 mm in diameter. These rechargeable waters are within spec, but around a quarter of a millimeter larger than these alkaline AAAs. The safety issue here is how the casing of the peeled battery can now touch the conducting inner wall of the laser pointer, making a short circuit of the batteries possible. Batteries do not respond well to being short circuited. This combination here is particularly bad since this is a case negative battery in a case positive laser pointer, opening several paths for short circuits if any or both of the batteries have a peel, even when placed in correct polarity orientation. In my experience, laser pointers for AAA batteries are all case positive designs. But are the batteries case negative or case positive? Here's a brief survey of some random AAA alkaline batteries I had lying around. Okay, Most of them are actually case positive. Only one was case negative, like the rechargeable Varta, and another one was a rather unusual case neutral. Here are some rechargeable ones for comparison. Interesting. All the rechargeable samples are case negative. So, surprisingly, the very Chinese Golden Power Alkaline, with its case neutral design, is the safest choice for any laser pointer where the battery compartment itself is part of the electrical circuit. No short-circuiting paths when the poles of the battery can't touch the inside of the tube. Nice. The second best choice for a common case positive laser pointer like this one are case-positive batteries. Though peeled case-positive batteries can still short-circuit when there are more than one battery in series. In this laser, a peeled case-positive battery raises another safety issue. If the second battery in has a peel, the laser will easily turn on by itself, even without the end cap attached. Yeah, I am glad most modern laser pointers don't have this dumb, unsafe design. This more common design with an on-off push button on the driver board cannot turn on just from a peel battery. But peel batteries can still be short-circuited, unless the inside of the tube is non-conductive. It does look coated. Maybe they did consider the risk. Nope. This older model is fully conductive on all of the inside too, relying on the batteries to provide the electrical insulation. Not great. However, this modern, dirt cheap model actually has a plastic tube to insulate even peeled batteries. The outer end is still conductive, but the plastic tube has a smaller inner diameter, holding the battery safely away from the metal tube. Finally, a great battery compartment design. Oh, wait a minute. The safety feature addressing peeled batteries. Peel standard sized batteries. That's dumb. Let's test something different. A laser using a single lithium ion battery. With only one battery, there's already less risk of short circuits. This laser is a case negative design. Good choice, since this 18650 battery is case negative too, like all the other rechargeable batteries from earlier. However, with only a button in the end cap, this one will also turn on if the battery is peeled and can make contact with the inner walls. Thankfully, they did consider this and covered the end cap and inside with non-conductive materials. Only the bare threads can conduct electricity. Well, okay, there are a few chips in the coating, so maybe don't trust it too much. They also made sure the springs can't easily bend onto the inner walls, which could short-circuit the battery poles to the inner walls. All in all, a decent battery compartment design. As long as right polarity orientation is respected for the battery, I don't see any risk of short-circuiting the battery, even if peeled. And if the battery is peeled, it is not likely to turn the laser on, because of the coatings. But this laser can still turn on when inserting the battery. The button is a latching switch. It stays on or off until pressed again. A problem when you can't see if it is in the on or off position. Well, you can measure it to check it is off before screwing it on, but who does that except me? Alright, peeled batteries should not be used in most lasers. But what if the batteries sort of come peeled from the factory? Like these case-positive button cells? Can you spot the good and bad battery compartment solutions in these two keychain lasers? Yeah, the difference in quality is staggering. They are both case-positive designs, the best choice for case-positive button cells. However, with three batteries in series, the risk of short circuits is high. The bad solution has nothing to center the spring in the tube. The good solution has a solid plastic cup that keeps the spring and batteries away from the inner wall. The bad solution only has a very thin, too short plastic film that can move around. Oh my! They saved fractions of a cent by cutting this film too short and small. I'm not impressed. After a short message, I will show you how a safe laser is designed when money is no object. A huge thank you to all my patrons. I appreciate your help with keeping these videos like this one coming. For just a dollar a month, you can help me out too and get full access to all my posts on patreon.com. Link in the description. Thank you. Alright, let's see how much it takes to make a battery-operated laser safe. I will use this discontinued thousands of dollars laser glow Hercules as an example. I'll be quiet while we just appreciate the safety details in the design. Good stuff. If a laser doesn't have all of these safety features, my advice is to not use peeled batteries in it. And always point the laser at a safe, non-specular surface when putting batteries in it, in case it should turn on by accident. Hope you enjoyed this video enough to click like and perhaps subscribe for more like it. In any case, thanks for watching. Bye for now.